pre-pandemic world and after-pandemic world going to be totally different worlds in the future. And safety and accessibility going to be very big players in this future world. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, safety and accessibility is the number one thing you have to think about when you're designing for humans, human scale.
Why? And,
well, you want everyone to feel safe and you want everyone to have access, regardless of whether you're, you know, are in a wheelchair or what your issue is. You need to have access like any other person. So safety and accessibility is always number one. But it's going to be just even more elevated because of COVID now. So I wanted to talk about earlier how people are creatures of habit and they require to be with other people. It's part of our instinct, is to be together. Nobody wants to be alone, and it's human nature. And with that in mind, COVID is messing with that concept.
Yeah.
And so it's bringing a lot of mental illness.
COVID divided people, right? So we have to stay home alone. We disconnected from our friends and families, and this is makes a big impact.
We want to be together. Yeah. We want to be together, but we're not going to risk our safety to be together. And that's the saddest part about this whole thing, I think. And what does the future look like when people are in big groups now? How are people going to feel when they're in a group or in one space with multiple other people? How can architecture help with that? How can we push design to make people feel safe when there's a lot of us together? It's a huge thing, and then it's a huge question to think about. So in the Lever House, what we did was we thought about the fabric of the building, the materiality that we choose to move forward with. And this is where innovation comes into play in future thinking. A material that can breathe in bacteria, that can breathe in germs, that can breathe in all the icky and filter it and produce clean air. What kind of material does that? How can we have material like that in a space where people see and they automatically feel safe? Because, oh, that's right there. I know I'm going to be okay. It is messing with the psyche at this point too. Also cleaning the air, right? But that's what we decided to do with our building, because our issue was not necessarily safety when we were thinking about this, because like I said, this was pre-COVID when we were designing it. It was conveniency. We wanted people to get into the building, to fly in through Uber Air, to enter. And we have a few different entrances for the different programs. But whichever way you enter into the building, you don't have to touch a single surface. You walk through and AI will recognize who you are. It'll automatically send you a link. And if you are meeting someone there, they're going to have their phone and you're going to know exactly where they are. You don't have to touch anything. You don't have to smell anything. You don't have to do anything. You are automatically, like, there's a security system. And this is like way out in the future. You know, we're like thinking here in conceptual world. But it's nice because we were thinking in terms of conveniency. I don't have time to check in, to do this, to do. I want to get in and get out. And that's what our thought process was. But how convenient is it that now it is a way of safety too? Right?
Yeah. Safety is a very important stuff, so, because people worry about it. And to tell you one story, somebody I know, like guy less than 30 years old, he got COVID. He quarantined for 2 weeks. He stayed home for 2 weeks and get back to work. And he's got phone calls and reached out from clinic to pretty much subsidize his blood for other COVID patients to help. And the clinic was testing his blood for antibodies. Right after COVID, he's have enough antibodies in his blood and will be in his blood was actually usable to help other patients. But within time, I'm talking about 6 months, every month he got less and less and less antibody. And within 6 months, he's pretty much got no antibody. And what that tells me, if he's going to go get sick again from COVID, he's going to actually get sick. Question is, for future architect design, what we should do to design buildings to eliminate touching any surfaces? I think that's going to be a big question for the future.
That's a really good question. My friend also got COVID and she had to quarantine for a while, but she's fine now and she's going to work and everything, but she can't smell. She still can't smell. And she was going on a date last night with a guy that she met on an app or something, and she's like, I'm so scared I'm gonna smell like shit, like I'm like BO, like I can't smell myself. And we were thinking, what if there was a device that is like part of your phone, maybe a chip or something that you can add, that you can just like, do I smell bad? Like, do I
smell
like
that? That's a very interesting idea.
You know, like it's just, it makes you think about what's the next way to mm-hmm. survive, what's the next way to adapt yeah. to this new life. And that's part of like Apple, like Androids, let's go, let's get this going, because you know, people are in need of this. People need to be together, and these are like simple everyday things that cross our mind all the time. Do I stink? Like, do I, what, you know, I can't taste. People are losing weight. They're not eating. It's like, it's a huge thing. I totally agree. And architecture and design is here to help. And it's almost like pushing us to get on it. Like we have to, and we've been wanting to for so long, but the world is afraid of change. People are afraid. You know how many times we want, like in school and even now with like clients, I'm pushing them constantly to change their layouts, to change for their functionality.
Really?
Yeah. And people are afraid of the change. That's what it is. And I think COVID is forcing you.
Yeah.
To make that change. Like, for example, going to the gym. You have to make a reservation in advance so yeah. that the gym knows how many people are going to be there. You can only come on the hour. You can only come at 3, 4, 5, 6. You can't come like at 3:30.
Yeah.
How inconvenient is that for your life? You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to plan your whole life around this disease that's eating at us instead of taking control of it. And like, we are letting it control us instead of figuring out how we can control it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't know. Just.
Yeah. It's a very interesting concept.